Hello student, a very good morning to all. In the previous video, I had already discussed about some definition of communication, communication cycle, and also discussed about the some elements of communication, which are mostly used for making and establishing a communication. So now we are continuing our first lesson, and today onwards, we will discuss about the communication methods. So how many methods are used for making a communication? So here the some methods are given. So the first of all here, these are a method for making a communication. So first one is communication, it may be a verbal, yeah, communication it may be a non-verbal. So non-verbal means some written works, and audio-visual. So audio-visual means if sender communicate to the receiver, so in this condition, yeah, in this method, sender send the information with using some animation or yeah, picture. So that type of communication, it is known as a audio visual communication. So this method is a most important role for making a good communication. So now here the definition of communication method. So communication is something we do even when we will think we are not communicating. So according to the communication method, first of all, the sender and the receiver is doing something. Otherwise, the communication will not be established. If sender and the receiver both are thinking, then how can be the communication? So first of all, when we have to making a communication and making a establishing a communication, so first of all, both sender and the receiver are active. So here, these are methods. So we will discuss about one by one each method. So first of all, we will discuss about the verbal. So verbal means this type of method will be covered the face-to-face communication, yeah, fir WhatsApp call, Facebook call, yeah, fir video call. So this type of communication, it is known as a verbal. So here the definition of verbal communication. So these tools of verbal communication are words and grammar of the language used in communication. So in this type of method, we are using some words and grammar for making a communication. So verbal communication has two forms, either oral communication or fir written communication. So oral communication, it is a communication is like as a face-to-face या फिर वीडियो कॉल. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इट इज नोन एज अ ओरल कम्युनिकेशन. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन अकर्स फेस टू फेस व्हाइल वर्ड्स आर स्पोकन. सो इट इज द इजिएस्ट एंड द इफेक्टिव वे ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. सो द मैसेज ट्रेवल्स फास्टेस्ट टू द रिसीवर एंड एनकोडेड क्विकली एंड फीडबैक इज गिवन ऑलमोस्ट इन द रियल टाइम. सो दीज ऑल प्रोसेस आर in real time process. So there have some factor for making a oral communication. So the first method is proficiency of language. So the sender and the receiver need to have workable command over the language for smooth decoding or encoding of the message exchange. So these also include correct pronunciation. Means suppose that sender send the any information from the receiver. So in this condition, the sender send a correct pronunciation and use the correct pronunciation words for making a communication. So desired vocabulary and knowledge of basic grammar of the language. So this type of factor of oral communication. Now after that, the second point is assent, pass and clarity. So first we'll discuss about these three points. So first of all, this assent means, so India have a many states, and the many states have different reasons. So here the different reasons have a different languages. So the people from different regions have different ways of speaking. So this is called a assent, because the different region have a different knowledge and language. So this type of condition of environment, it is called the assent. And then after, how fast or slow the person speaks make the pace for speaking means some person are speaking is very fast and some person are speaking is very slow. So that is a passive for speaking. And how clearly the words and delivered makes for the clarity of the speech. So these three terms are very important for making a and establishing a oral communication. Volume, mood and emotion. So these are a factor of oral communication. So here the first one is, first point is volume. So volume means if the sender speak is highly volume. So in this condition the communication are negatively. So the fundamental set of emotions during the communication makes for the mood of the sender and the receiver. Then after we will discuss about the next factor of communication is duration of communication. So here the duration of communication means how long the communication are established. So here how long the communication must add and is going on affect the interest level of the participant. So if we will communicate a long period of communication, so in this case the receiver are disinterested. So that time the communication are failure. So here are some advantage of oral communication. So the first point is it involves no or least expenses. It save a lots of time. And then third point is immediate feedback is collected and message can be encoded accordingly. Fourth point is interpersonal nature develop relations. Next point, most effective in resolving conflicts and difficulty situation and promote cooperation and teamwork. So these are advantages of oral communication. And there have some disadvantage of oral communication is it has no legal value. It has no importance in the court of law because all communication are orally, so there have no any written work. So this is a disadvantage of oral communication. So no liability, accountability and reference value on what has been agreed upon during the communication. So that type of disadvantage of oral communication. And then after we will discuss about the next method of communication is written communication. So according to this written communication involves written words. So there have some written words are involved. So this type of communication, it is known as a written communication. So most of such communication is formal, like as letters, reports, notice, newsletter, resume. So these are a formal factor which are mostly used in written communication. So email, SMS and chat are other mode of written communication. So this is a technical word or technological written work. So there have email, SMS and chat for other mode of written communication. So written communication needs to be clear and point to point and correct in order to convey its right meaning and intent the receiver. So here is also some advantage of written communication and disadvantage of written communication. So the first of all we will discuss about the advantage of written communication. So writing has the advantage of having time for the choice of suitable vocabulary and tone of the message. So message can be reviewed and revised before sending. Then the second point is it is legally acceptable in the court of law if executed in proper way. Third point is longer message can be conveyed in written form. And the next point is written message can be saved for the later references. So these are advantage of written communication. And the disadvantage of written communication means it takes a long time, or means written communication is time taking. Means if we will talk about the oral communication, so oral communication is the fast way of communication, but written communication have taking a time period of. So that's why the disadvantage of written communication is this one. Written communication is time taken.